A study conducted by the Public Procurement and Disposal of Public Assets Authority, aimed at ascertaining entity participation in public procurements, revealed that only 1% of all the contracts were for women. This fact, among other competing realities, prompted the government to reconsider accelerating not only women's but also people with disabilities and youth's engagement in government procurements.
The guideline is on the long-awaited reservation schemes to promote the participation of registered associations of women, youth, and persons with disabilities. This guideline aims at facilitating the participation of women, youth, and persons with disabilities in the public procurement processes.
The ministry noticed and came to a consensus with other stakeholders to centralize these groups as a way of bridging the long-existent parity. However, these benefits shall only be enjoyed by registered individuals or companies.
Associations of women, youth, or persons with disabilities owned enterprises may take the form of an incorporated companies, partnerships, savings and cooperative societies, or owned community-based organizations. In other words, what we are saying here, if you are a youth and you own a company, irrespective of whether you belong to an association or not, still you qualify to get a contract.
Special groups will hence compete favorably in government procurement bids with the general interested groups. Differently though, special groups are exempted from bidding fees and securities. These incentives, as revealed by Minister Musasizi, will enhance employment, encourage high production and boost income equality across the board.
Provided for simplified bidding procedures for the women, youth, and the persons with disabilities registered associations, for example, submit bid securing declaration for instead of bid security and exemption from paying bidding fees while participating in the procurement process under the reservation scheme.
In a later conversation with the Executive Director of the Public Procurement and Disposal of Public Assets Authority, Benson Turamie, revealed that as an authority, they have since intensified efforts to engage with councils of all special groups of women, youths and people with disabilities. The authority bids to aid these groups in capacity building on how to prepare bids, open bank accounts and to encourage them to associate amongst themselves, since individuals or companies to benefit from the new incentives must have their businesses registered. Derek Asaba reporting for the news.